Roll the thighs out. Roll the elbows forward, open the hands. Roll the pelvis in a little bit. Drop the sacrum down. Drop the chin down, but lift the back of the head up. And just feel how your body feels right now. Feel your chi. Get your head to float above your chest. Get your head and your chest to float above your belly. And feel the energetic line of connection between your head, your chest, and your belly. Feel that line as it connects down into the earth, up above your head. Take a deep breath. Breathe in, expand your belly. Expand your belly to the front, the sides, the back. Expand your belly as you breathe in. Now, as you expand your belly, let it expand downwards so that it also opens up the space of your pelvic cavity. Expansion moving into your pelvis as your belly expands, pressing forwards the pubic bone, the genital region, pressing down to the perineum, back to the tailbone, the sacrum. Expand your belly, then expand into your solar plexus, feeling the lower ribs move forward and also out to the sides, and also the lower ribs opening into the back. Now, three-stage in-breath, expanding your belly, your solar plexus, and then breathing into the back of your chest, the sides of your chest. Drop your chin down, lift the back of your head up, elongate your thoracic spine, sink your shoulders. Feel the ribs separating from each other in your back. Breathing with a three-stage in-breath so that you expand into the back of the chest, the sides of the chest, you breathe up into the armpits. And as you breathe out, relax, let everything sink down. Okay, let's do the first of the eight brocades to start with, to get the primary channels open. Breathing in, bring the chi up the spine. Breathing out, down the front midline of the body. Breathing in, expand the belly. Breathing out, let the belly sink down, press down to the perineum. And breathing in, pull up and in on the pelvic floor muscles, the belly muscles. Breathing out, let the belly expand and sink again. When you pull the muscles up and in, only use about 60% of your capacity. Opening the spinal channel, separating the vertebrae from each other. And breathing out, feel the front midline sinking down, descending. Expand the belly as you breathe in. and the chong mai, sink the chi down, let the belly expand and sink. Now pull the belly in, pull the pelvic floor muscles up, lift the spine, the du mai, and then bring the chi down the front midline, the ren mai. Expand the belly, the chong, the central tube of energy up the middle of your body, down to the perineum, and then the du mai up the back. Feel the spine and feel the energy channels either side of the spine. As the energy comes down the front midline, feel it coming down either side of the front midline, as well as the front midline. Chong mai as you breathe in, chong mai as you breathe out. The du mai up your spine. And then also push the chi out to the base of the palms, describing an oval of energy around you, a luminous oval of energy, the dai mai. So as you breathe out, the chi comes down the front midline and also extends around you, in an oval shape, down, around you, underneath the ground. Okay, good. Standing weighted. So breathing in. And moving to your right, breathing out. Breathing in. And breathing out. Three-stage in-breath. Expand the belly, solar plexus, the back of the chest, and then breathe out. Breathe in, white sparkling energy, and breathe out. Expand the belly, solar plexus, back of chest, and breathe out. Breathing in. Let's just hold the position right here for a minute. Start to attune your mind to the energy under the ground. Tune into rocks, crystals, and metals. Let your weight sink down through you. As you breathe in, I want you to imagine and feel that you can draw into you the chi from the underground seams of rock and crystal, a white, fluid, sparkling energy, the chi of metal. Requesting it to respond to you, requesting it to come up into your body, taking deep, full, relaxed breaths. Allow gravity to sink down through you. You want to feel the pressing force of gravity and say yes to it, open our bodies to it. Gravity will connect us to metal. And then as you breathe in, drawing the streams of energy from the underground sources of metal up into your body. Imagining and feeling this white sparkling energy coming up through your bone structure. Your bones respond to the pressure of gravity. They become stronger, they also become more flexible. Your bones are composed of microcrystalline hydroxyapatite. They have a crystalline structure, so your bones can absorb the metal energy. Feel yourself as a skeleton. Take deep in-breaths, absorbing energy into your skeleton, as if your skeleton can breathe. You might notice a kind of electrical quality as you breathe through your skeleton. And in fact, your bones do generate piezoelectric currents all the time. Requesting the healing forces of crystals, metals, rocks to respond to you, to flow up into your body. Letting your blood sink down so that your blood presses down into contact with this gravitational force. Of course, each of your red blood cells works with elements, iron. Different parts of your body work with copper. Magnetic compounds accumulate in your pineal gland. Your body can refine and even transmute metals. Contacting the energy of metals. Okay, we're going to continue with the Qigong. Reach down, breathe in, and then breathing out. Breathing in. Now starting to feel the lightness of air. Breathing in, gathering the energy of air and cloud and mist and sky. Filling your body with it. Breathing in, requesting the energy of the air, the healing chi of the air to respond to you. Come into your body. Deep full breaths. Open your hand, draw the energy of the sky and the clouds into your body, and let it sink down through your body from above. Requesting the sky energy to come into your body. You start to feel that you can breathe through all the pores of your skin. Breathing in sparkling, translucent energy from above. Requesting the healing forces of air to respond to you. Filling your lungs and your sinus cavities physically with air. the sinus cavities expanding. And as you breathe out, feel the air, chi sinking down into your belly, sinking through your whole body. Moving with an awareness of energy channels that radiate off of your chest. It's said in Chinese medical text that the lungs rule the 100 channels. That means that the energy of your lungs pumps qi through channels that radiate from your chest through the rest of your body. Letting your chest expand and fill, and as you breathe out, feeling the qi extend down through the rest of your body. Okay, standing Wuji. Continue to take deep, full breaths. Let's just enjoy the capacity to breathe. Smiling as you breathe, so that as you breathe, your smiling energy is carried down through the rest of your body. Expanding your belly as you breathe in, and your solar plexus, then the back of your chest. Opening into the back lower portion of the lungs, this lobe of the lungs normally doesn't open unless you sigh or yawn. But right now we want to open the back of the lungs. It's this lower posterior lobe of each lung that connects your breath to your kidneys. Your kidneys lie underneath your lowest ribs. We want to connect the breath qi to the kidney qi. In this way, we link what's called the Houtianzhi qi with the Xiantianzhi qi. That means we link the qi that starts when you take your first breath through your lungs and your nose. We link that with the qi that begins in the embryo and runs through the navel, runs through the umbilical cord. These two circuits of qi move in the body continuously. The lung qi, breath qi, is of course more airy, more of an alternating current. And the kidney qi, the pre-birth qi, embryonic qi, is a little bit more granular, more of a direct current. We want to link these two forms of qi in the body, and we do this through deep abdominal breathing. When we talk about the element of metal in Chinese philosophy, on one level we mean metal, crystal, rock. And that process of crystallization. On another level, we mean air and wind and cloud and sky. And on another level, we mean the radiance of sound and light, the resonance of sound, the radiance of light. So now we're going to do a Qigong to connect in a little bit to more to the sky and air energies. So we're going to work with cloud hands, breathing in, breathing out. Breathing in, moving your hands like clouds. Very relaxed, very soft. The idea in this Qigong is that your feet are sunk down deep into the earth, as if you have cables of energy going down into the earth, anchoring you into the bedrock. And your waist is moving like ocean waves, like water. And your upper body and your chest are moving like air, like mist, like clouds. And so this is called cloud hands. Your head is up above the clouds in the clear sky, connecting to light. So breathing in, as the hand passes your mouth, the lower hand thumb is going to point into your region right beneath your belly. The upper hand, breathing in as the hand passes your mouth, breathing out as the hands turn and change. Letting the inside of your body be filled up with a cloud energy, a soft energy. Feeling what it's like to move with cloud consciousness. It's very still and soft, quiet, peaceful. Now bring the feet together. Reach up above your head and touch your middle fingers together. Breathe in. Draw the middle fingers down to your forehead region. Hold the breath in. Imagine a trail of starlight descending your front midline. Turn your hands over, let the belly expand, and then breathe out. Hold this position, breathe in. I want you to imagine a star of light above you. It comes contact yet. It comes down to your forehead. Tongue is on the roof of the mouth. A trail of starlight descends through the front midline of the body, down into your belly. You let your belly expand and then you breathe out. Okay, let's reach up again above the head. Touch the middle fingers together and then breathe in as the middle fingers approach the forehead, looking upwards a little bit. And then hold your breath in and let your hands descend the front midline whilst holding your breath in, imagining a trail of starlight descending in front of your body and through your body. Let the belly expand and then breathe out. Sinking the chi down to Guan Yuan, energy gate, about two-thirds of the way from your belly to your pubic bone. Deep in-breath, hold the breath in and recreate that energetic pattern without the movements. The star of light from above you, requesting the star of light of your own consciousness, your own soul energy to gather above you, to descend down through you, to take up residence inside your belly. Okay, and reaching up again. Requesting that light of your own soul energy to respond to you, to descend down through the different planes of consciousness, to come into yin tang, energy center of your forehead. Feeling it descending the front midline, sparkling, trailing starlight. The belly expand, breathe out. Deep in breath. So far we've worked with the first Qigong to really open the channels and also open the lower Dantian to absorb the metal rock crystal aspect of the metal Qi. And we worked with, you know, cloud hands to really focus on the air, sky, wind aspect of this Qi. And we've worked with this last Qigong to connect to the radiance, the light aspect. Qi. Now we're going to actually work with a Qigong that will bring all three into unison. So you want to have your feet shoulder width apart, not too wide for this Qigong, even slightly less than shoulder width potentially. So breathing in and breathing out. This is a Qigong taken from Xing Yi Pi Chuan. So breathing in, deep, full, three-stage in-breath, connecting to that light energy above, and then drawing the energy straight down through your body. Now we're moving from metal, the fluid energy of air and chi movement, to light, and then from light down to metal, and then down into the earth. So this Qigong is known as an axe. It's like a heavy metal axe descending. So we're connecting to some of the sharp cutting aspects of the metal Qi. The metal Qi has to do with cutting through to the truth. It has to do with discerning what's true, and what's right, what's just, and cutting away what isn't. So the metal chi in the body has to do with releasing and letting go what is not necessary. It's the autumn, so it's a great time to work on the metal chi a little bit. Also to welcome it in. Working with the metal qi strengthens the lungs, strengthens the immunity, and stores energy. So bring the qi up your spine, over your head, down the front midline, and out to your hand. Breathing in as the hand comes up, breathing out as the hand goes down. I want you to imagine and feel the qi extending beyond your hand, like a cutting edge, a sharp edge extending out an inch or two beyond your hand. And as you breathe out, transferring the weight to the opposite side, to the hand that's descending, sink the qi down through your heels into the ground. Breaths, establishing the circle of energy up your back, up your spine, over your head, gathering the heavenly energy, bringing it straight down through your heel into the earth. See if you can feel yourself energetically connecting your weight and your center axis down to the seams of rock and crystal under the ground. And as you breathe in, as you reach the top of your in-breath, just a momentary energetic pause to connect to the radiance of light. Standing Wuji. Take some deep breaths, relax your body. Feel the energy in your body. Chinese thinking, each element has corresponding organ systems in the body. So we're going to do some very simple qigongs to work with the organs that are connected with the metal qi. So we're going to start with a very simple qigong for the large intestine. Breathe in, breathe out. And as you breathe out, just let your belly relax and sink. People often use this qigong as a warm-up qigong for Tai Chi classes and so on. It's quite good for that. It's also quite a good grounding qigong. If you've been doing a lot of meditation or a lot of things that take you into a subtler energy state and you want to get grounded, this is quite good. This qigong is also quite useful for shaking energy out of your body. If you're a healer or you've picked up some energies somewhere, this is quite useful. Remember, the metal qi is responsible for eliminating that which you don't need. Right? It's also quite connected to the elimination of the demonic energies. Right? The demonic energies of our own instinctive nature are said in some Taoist thinking to enter through the mouth and exit through the anus. So you take the energy because the large intestine is associated with the metal chi. So you take the energy and you just sink it out through your belly, out through your feet, out through your hands. And as you let the hands sink down, you want to let the tiger's mouth expand a little bit. Now, the tiger's mouth is right here, and this is a metal energy right here. It has to do with the lung and the large intestine and acupuncture channel. So you just open the tiger's mouth. Let's get a little releasing going. This Qigong is very useful for people who have constipation. You have them do this 100 times every morning, every night. It gets the belly moving. You can also pull the belly muscles in as you come up and relax, release them as you breathe out. Don't do that too forcefully. All right, good. Now we're going to do a little Qigong that's very specific to the lungs. This Qigong is often taught as part of the Taoist Five. It's very simple. It's also rather tiring at times on the shoulders, so we won't do it for too long. So breathing in, feel your lungs filling, and now don't worry about just breathing into the back of your lungs. You can breathe into the back, the sides, and the front of the lungs. And I also want you to breathe into the bottom of the lungs and the top of the lungs. And smile down into your lungs. The lungs are known in Chinese medicine as the delicate organ, because lungs often carry a kind of sensitivity. Lungs have to process letting go of the emotions in the emotional body. In just the same way as the large intestine lets go of the toxins for the physical body, the lungs process the letting go of our emotional life. So the lungs are naturally connected to sadness and to the grief of loss, passing of loved ones, and allowing ourselves to feel any residual sadness or grief. And also, it really, I think, needs to be understood. The lungs are connected to a certain degree of existential pain. The lungs are connected to the ancestors. The ancestors live inside you. So smiling into your lungs, thanking your lungs and letting yourself feel that sensitivity of energy in your emotional body. Very soft, gentle movement. You can make the movement a little bit smaller. Bring your hands a little closer to you. Filling your lungs with white, sparkling energy. The lungs are also associated with innocence. That innocent quality that you retain within you, the inner child that is really so essentially who you are. Bringing the hands in closer to your chest, smaller movement. Bring your feet in a little bit, bring your hands in even closer. Now just making a small motion. Breathing in, open the hands out. Breathing in the beneficial energies of your ancestors, breathing out. It's sense of gratitude and appreciation. Letting your lungs fully open. Lungs are connected to reflection, and the fall, the autumn, is a time of reflection, a time when the energies start to turn inwards. Alright, good. The third fundamental organ of the metal energies in the body is the sinus cavities, and we're going to do a Qigong to work with the four types of sinus cavity and the four consciousness embodiments that those represent. So the first sinus cavities we're going to work with are the maxillary sinuses right here. Now the sinuses form a ring around this point right here. This point right here is known as yin tang. And yin tang literally means the place where the emperor or the empress puts her stamp, her seal of approval upon the orders. This is an interesting reflection upon the function of the pituitary gland as the master gland for your whole body. So, around yin tang, you have the frontal sinuses here, you have the maxillary sinuses here, you have the ethmoid sinuses here, and then way in the back in a little sphere, you have the sphenoid sinus, the singular sinus, okay? So we're going to do four little exercises to work with each of these sinus cavities and to work with the consciousness embodiments that those can represent. So starting off, we're going to bring the hands up towards the base, the top of the cheekbones, and then down again. And we're going to work with the maxillary sinuses. So breathing in, imagine white sparkling energy coming up into your sinuses, and then breathing out, just pulling the energy out from your sinuses a little bit. Now the maxillary sinuses have to do with embodying your qi. They literally have to do with vitality, the strength, power, and vitality of your energy field, and how that energy field acts as a template for your physical vitality. This is why in the Nei Jing there's a very mysterious statement that the ruling of all of your bones occurs from right in the middle of your cheek here. It has to do with how your body embodies vitality. So as you breathe in and absorb the spiritual laws of qi embodiment, of vitality. Just absorbing gold and silver colors into your maxillary sinuses, gold and silver energies. See if you can feel those sinus cavities. Now the nose and the sinuses in general have to do with sniffing out the path. Just the same way that a wolf would follow the trail of its prey for many, many miles by sniffing, by smelling. So the human being is oriented in the right spiritual direction through the spiritual function of the sinus cavities and the nose. You want to activate that knowing of the laws of manifesting strong qi, strong physical vitality. Now we're going to work with the frontal sinuses up here. It's kind of shaped like this, this little shape there. So we're going to pull energy into the frontal sinuses like this. So pulling in white sparkling energy or translucent energy into your forehead. See if you can feel that sinus cavity, fill it up with this sparkling energy. And as you do so, absorb into yourself the laws of manifesting in the mental realm. Here is your mental power. Here is where you decide and enact how you want to manifest your life. Absorbing the spiritual laws of mastery of the mental world, the mental universe. Here is the seat of equanimity. Drawing in a diamond-like quality, yet liquid, fluid, into the frontal sinuses. All right, good. Now sink your chi down into your belly. Good. Now we're going to work with the ethmoid sinuses. The ethmoid sinuses lie right inside here. They go inwards. And the ethmoid sinuses have to do with the laws of the spiritual world. So we're going to reach down, breathe in, and then draw the energy inwards along the inside of the eye sockets. See if you can feel into the ethmoid sinus cavities. And see if you can feel into the laws of manifesting in the spiritual world. Allow that to occur to you as it needs to, and then sink the energy down to your heels. You're going to bring the energy in through the eye sockets, but then as you breathe out, bring the hands down, sink the energy down through your kidneys, through your hips, through your heels. We want to stay grounded as we do this. The laws of manifesting in the spiritual realm. Pause for a second or two. Feel into that a little bit, what that means, and then breathing out, sink the chi down. Notice the fluid and non-stopping energy of the spiritual realm. One more time. All right, good. Now, bring the legs together. Turn the thighs in so that they're touching each other. Lastly, we're going to work with the sphenoid sinus. The sphenoid sinus is this little spherical space. It's underneath a bone called the cellar tussica, and on top of the cellar tussica sits your pituitary gland. It's a very interesting place inside your skull. It's kind of directly back and in. So the sphenoid sinuses hold the energy of the manifesting of the realm of ecstatic equilibrium, or the realms of enlightenment, if you like. Hold the breath in. And then breathe out. Breathing in. Hold the breath in. Bring your energy back into the sphenoid cavity. Tune into the laws of manifesting ecstatic equilibrium. This is as if you were in contact with your future self, your higher selves, that are resting in a state of infinite consciousness, and relaxed with it, at ease with it, embodied with it. Feel the alignment of your spine all the way up through your head, all the way down through your sacrum. One more time. Pulling down the heavens. We definitely want to do grounding exercise after that last one. So pulling down the heavens, you're going to let something kind of heavy press down through you from above, like the heavy descending energy of the heavenly realms. And as you do so, you're going to let it comb through your energy fields. Let it comb through everything. Firstly, using your fingers to comb through the energy fields in the front of your body. And then in the sides of your body. Relaxing as you descend, finding your own speed. And in the back of your body. Bring the feet closer together. Make the movement smaller. Sink the chi down into your belly. Sinking the chi into your belly, drawing the chi into your belly. Good. So, thanks for being here.